excellence. You earn everything. Hi guys, and welcome back to my Drag Race Season 11 live reaction series, and we are here for episode 3. Toi, Drei, Oklu. But really quickly, before I get on with the live reaction, we just have to talk about the meme that is going around right now. Opulence! You earn everything! Or is it earn? Or is it opulence? Opulence. So I've been seeing this like all over Instagram all week. It is absolutely hilarious. I think it basically has become the new Miss Vanjie for season 11. Probably not as big, but it is still hilarious. So I just wanted to share a couple of the ones that I've seen because I just think it's hilarious. I know you've probably all seen it, but we just needed to talk about it because it's opulence. So first up we have turbulence. You'll spill everything. Maintenance, you delay everything. Violence, you fight everything. Opulence, we own everything. We are New York. And finally, all my days, Shangela Laquifa Wadley posted a picture of her looking gorgeous and beat the face, the mug. She's just stunning, absolutely incredible. Stood there with a frying pan. Actually, there's two pictures, and she's like, oh, panlands, I fry everything. I live, oh my God, seriously, so funny. So that is just so hilarious. I live, oh my God, seriously. Mercedes Amon Diamond, thank you for that. Opulence, you earn everything. But I think there's probably more, so let me know in the comments below if you've like seen any other ones. I was trying to think of one, but I couldn't really think of anything, and I'm probably like, oh well, they're probably all done at this point, but I want to see more because it's just so funny. So without any further ado, let's crack on with the live reaction of episode Opulence.
Mercedes Iman Diamond, Shantae Yuste.
Thank you.
Kahana Montrese. Sashay away.
Oh yes, we lost Kahana. Kahana Unana. No, it's Kahana. Kahana
was just eliminated and it sucks, but this is like the fucking plains of Africa. Eat or be eaten.
Somebody gotta go. It was only week two.
But girl, I was like, I can't go home. I give everything for this.
Mercedes wanted to stay. We got the message. But Mercedes wants to turn out these challenges.
That lip sync, seriously, wow. Mm-hmm. Is she gonna be the lip sync assassin this season? We shall see.
You're struggling in all the categories. You gotta pick a struggle. You can't struggle in everything, bitch. Yo, go home.
You gotta pick a struggle. Don't struggle in everything. Okay, like.
This should have been my challenge. I feel like I'm fading away. I need to like figure out how to be a star in a room full of stars.
If you've got a room full of stars, step it up.
And I hope I send a message to anyone who maybe is discounting me.
To be fair, yes. Like, she was down there for me and now she's up here.
Ariel is a social media girl. So I think it's a difference for her being in a situation where she's with real entertainers. She's one note. She don't really have a personality. She's an Instagram hoe. Nobody care. Nobody here.
Oh, clue, but we don't need a shame the social medias.
I woke up this morning, there's one less hoe, and I feel great. Ooh, girl. She done ready to have hers.
My queen.
Ooh, get you to some church.
Queenliness is next to godliness.
Yes,
can
what?
Can I get an amen? Amen.
Can I get a gay man?
The year is 1990.
Girl. I wasn't even born then. For real.
Seduction, featuring Michelle Visage. I wonder whatever happened to her.
I don't know. I wonder whatever happened to Merle Ginsburg.
I got 9.5 reasons why Michelle Visage wants me in this back door, baby.
Well, show me at least one of them.
I twerk, boo.
There's a half reason.
A half?
Mercedes.
How do you spell that?
It's M-E-R-C-K-E-S.
Is that Mercedes?
Yes.
Mercedes.
Name three seduction songs.
Okay. Seduction, seduct, and selectivity. Girl, two things make a thing go right, girl.
If you're such a good friend of Michelle Visage, what's her middle name?
You tell me her middle name since you know so much about her.
Well,
titties.
I'm all up in the party. You know what?
No, you're checking the dough.
That attitude.
Name five seduction songs.
Did they even have that many songs? Reading.
I'm to understand one Michelle Visage is performing here tonight.
That is okay, that's funny. Method, I like that, oh my god.
You need to move along, ma'am.
Nina
you
West,
cannot
wow.
Come up in here, I'm sorry.
I would like to see my mom.
I'm gonna have to call Child Protective Services on you. Or a dentist.
Oh, girl.
Bitch, that ain't gonna get you nowhere.
I'm gonna football tackle this dough, honey.
I'd like to see you try.
Do it. Oh, my God.
1, 2, 3. Oh.
Oh. You hear that siren?
Only thing I hear is come in, Silky. Oh, you told me to come in. I'm here, honey.
Okay, so she took it that one step too far for a change. I think Nina West should win that.
Nina West and Raja O'Hara.
Whoa, come on, bitch.
Not gonna hate. Okay, cool. Well, she won.
Diva worship. For this week's Maxi Challenge, you'll be starring in 2 She-Vangelical talk shows.
Ooh! Oh my god, the talk show one from season 9 is like one of my favorites. Also season 3.
Divine pop diva. Of your choice.
2 groups though, again. 2 weeks in a row.
Miss Banji.
Oh, Jesus.
Come on, Miss Plasti.
Oh, thank you, Jesus.
Chicago.
I'm not surprised that Akira is still there. I haven't noticed Akira yet in this competition.
She's kind of been fading at the background a little bit. Great run, Rays. I did like her in the acting challenge last week where she was on the phone. It's no surprise that Mercedes was picked last because she did struggle with the words last week, as we all know. Miss Banji in that pink tracksuit is so cute. I want one. I want me a Miss Banji.
If we pick with Whitney, it kind of gets sensitive only because a lot of her moments were situations where she, you know, was in a bad place.
She wasn't in control.
Yeah. Right. Mariah.
Asia O'Hara didn't do Whitney because of such for the Snatch Game.
We are thinking collectively we'll have enough knowledge on Mariah.
No, ma'am.
Oh, I thought you were saying you
were. I love her, but I'm the worst person at memory.
I don't really know, like, anything about Mariah either, like her music or anything that she's done or known sort of things from award shows. I don't even know. I don't know much about Mariah.
Honey.
Emotions.
I get so emotional, baby. Yeah.
Wasn't that not Whitney Houston? So emotional. I thought we were talking about Mariah Carey. They say no Sasha Velour, so emotional. We're talking about Mariah Carey.
Who's decided that we was doing Mariah? Knows anything either.
We just gotta pull together like what all the facts are.
Does anybody know anything about Mariah Carey right now? Cause like, I don't, they don't. Why did they choose Mariah?
Everybody says the exact same thing. Oh, well this time I'm gonna get up there, I'm gonna be acting all good. I know exactly what I'm gonna do this time, Mr. Paul.
You gotta make it memorable and work the best every single week. Don't be in the bottom and be like, I'm gonna do better next week, and then come into the acting challenge and be all timid and like mess your words up. So you gotta work it and do it. Don't give out empty promises. Oh, cloop.
Look, I've been the number one bitch in the game for 25 motherfucking years. Ain't another bitch come for me.
Ain't nobody else gonna take that away.
Let the church say amen.
Amen.
We went through a bunch of divas, and it was the one we all collectively knew about the most.
Okay. Do any of you belong to the Mariah Carey fan club?
You literally...
That's a no.
It's not too late to change, girl. You clearly don't know anything. Like, no.
The Carries.
No, okay. They're her lambs.
Oh, nice.
Yeah, you bitches ain't done no homework.
Wouldn't have known that. I think they should switch.
How are you gonna convert somebody into a Mariah fan? Someone's gotta be an authority. Is there an authority in your group on Mariah Carey?
There go them crickets again.
What the fuck have you been doing all this time?
I think you need to switch divas. Mariah's a diva, but if you don't know shit about her...
We're kind of pulling all
we're
the
We're just kind of pulling from
together.
All of our common knowledge.
Which is very little. It's very little, isn't it?
Mm-hmm.
Bring up your Mariah-isms.
Six people or how many people are there? Six people pulling their zero Mariah knowledge together equates to zero. That's just math. It's Britney Bitch Network.
My name is Nina West, your host today of the Give Me More Hour of Power prayer session. Welcome as we worship our deity, the Holy Britney Jean Spears. We have set up the Leave Britney Alone Foundation.
Leave Britney alone!
Nina is setting the mood, baby, and she's selling it to me.
Mm-hmm. I'm impressed with Nina. Stepping it up.
Can I get a Britney?
Britney!
Pick two whores that don't know shit about Britney. That they don't know about hitting me, baby. They don't know about oops, I did it. They don't know about the hair whipping. They don't know about work, bitch. They don't know about Lucky.
I love Lucky. Oh my God.
Thank you, Britney.
Okay, like I'm, wow, sold. I mean, you can't swear on primetime television, but.
We taking it down to 2007. I'm attempting the Britney skeptic.
That works so well, actually. Oh my God, wow.
You helped me break the ice, yes. And I am stronger than yesterday.
Thank you, Miss Fancy. Thank myself. And you too, Britney.
Awkward. Ooh la la.
Have you ever heard of Mrs. Spears?
What is Spears? What's Britney? Where I'm from, we only have is Spears.
Girl.
I think they missed the lines.
If it worked on this, it will work on this. All right.
I feel like I feel like Mercedes has just fucked it up.
Yes,
I feel like Miss Vanjie kind of like messed up the opening words for Mercedes to come in, so it kind of messed her up, but Miss Vanjie kind of stuck with it and was fine, so I won't hold it against you, Miss Vanjie.
Come to the lab, my friend, cause oops, we did it again.
Oh. All right, Sister Silky, you better work, bitch. We're knocking on Britney's door. You're gonna Give me more.
You better work, bitch!
Ow. That's a cut.
great team. They were all so good, except potentially Mercedes. But I feel like it's going to be a team win, so she'll be safe within the team.
We're about to convert these sheeps into these lambs.
That's kind of backwards, but I get the Mariah lamb reference, but okay.
Can I get a
girl, what's going on here?
Already they don't even know, like, references. I don't even know, so I don't know what's going on. I'm confused. Peppermint's confused. We're all fucking confused. This is a circus. It's toxic. She ain't even a girl. She's not yet a woman.
And we're in commercial.
Thank God. Wow. Someone's going home from this team. They're driving me crazy.
Not everything has to be live, Miss Sugar, okay?
That is true, honey.
Especially vocals.
Especially when it's Mariah.
Me and my girls, Morocco and Moreau, are so happy to have found a long-lost lamb passed out in the sidewalk
of an Ariana Grande.
One last time fellowship.
This glitter can power for, it can power through anything. Miss Honey, I think we ought to sing these people a song.
In just a minute, because I need to let y'all know before we sing this song.
What you...
The love do take time, Ooh. But you two can join into Camp Moriah, honey.
Yeah, I'm with Ross right now.
She keep bending notes. Girl, you bending notes. You supposed to stick with the melody, girl.
They're both off. Should have been touching their ears and saying I'm having a technical difficulty.
That would have been funny, but mm-mm.
If you can't make it happen, let Moriah make it happen.
Well, they definitely couldn't make it happen, so...
Cut! We're clear.
Thank God that's over. I hope Moriah never sees this.
Bring it on the runway. Thank you.
Overall, I think our team is, headed to the gate.
Whoever has the worst looks this week out of that team, so they need to step it up. They need to. They will be fine when they believe.
I'm just not feeling confident about my team's challenge yesterday.
You shouldn't. Plastic's probably gonna be alright. Maybe Akiria might be alright, but...
Hey, I'm happy.
Hey. Hello?
What's going on?
The trade? And the Vanjie?
Cut a buddy type stuff.
But they're so cute and I like fancy them both. No. Actually, that would be really hot if they just got it on, but okay.
It might be some beautiful blossom from this workroom.
That's actually cute.
I'm Catholic, and when we go to church, you can't talk, you can't breathe, you can't do shit.
In a black church, you sit, you be quiet, but when they tell you to do something, like, sing.
So how the fuck did you manage?
I mean, she's got a point, though. Like, maybe she just sat there quiet the whole time, and now she's letting it all out.
For my look today, wow. I have to paint my entire body.
She painted her body gray last week, and now she's doing her whole body in pink? Like, girl, that is some commitment. Is she doing, like, Monet's Pink Panther?
Feeling my Alaska realness.
Oh my God.
Good Miss Evie, her meat is hanging out, and she is painted pink, as if she is the only person in the room.
No, there is 12 other queens and cameras and crew and everyone and viewers in the room, but she just don't care. Wow.
Welcome to the main stage of RuPaul's Drag Race. It's our Lady of the New Jersey Turnpike, Michelle Visage.
Ru looks good in green. That gown is nice. I like the hair, the green eyeshadow. I just wonder if Michelle will approve of the green.
It's Troy Sivan.
Hi, Ru.
It's Troy Sivan. We got YouTubers up in here, turn singers. Girl,
Category is... Fringe. Gentlemen, start your engines and may the best woman win. First up, Honey Davenport.
Ah, my VHS exploded.
Wow, okay.
My Fringe is inspired by Lady Gaga's Angel Down costume.
Yes, oh my God, wow. This, that's giving me like Trinity the Tuck. I like that. Cool. Fringe, she's good. Oh, I think I saw a bit of her hair. I did it again, the hair, when she moved. Wow.
Not to my native heritage.
Nice. I like that. I like the dark eye tribal situation. I think she might be okay after the main challenge because she turned it out with that look. Cute, gorgeous. People are going to read her for it being too plain. I like it. And it's very Alyssa House of Edwards.
Ponytail reminds me of
Ariana Grande.
Ariana Grande! I like it. Ooh, nice. Like, that is, like, extra. You think fringe, oh, we'll do a bit of fringe. No, I'm wearing the fringe. My headpiece is the fringe. This is, like, better than Pheromone's Vegas look. It's fringe. It's red. I quite like that hair. But this isn't anything compared to some of the other fringe looks. I think she's in trouble. That's cute. That's old school, fringy. Now you know what she's giving me. Oh my god, from week one, she's actually giving me Thorgy Thor right now from the clown hair entrance look of All Stars 3. But no, that is actually really good. Wow. Wow. Okay, Coachella, realness. It's kind of fringe. I don't want to be like, that's not fringe, because I don't know. But it's different fringe to what we've seen, so, but I like it. I like that, I do. It's like better version of Raja's. So you can't, like, hello, she's got the body glitter, she has that hair down there. She's even got the V-neck. It's like everything just is Vanjie. I just, yeah, no, I am impressed with that. That is.
Evie Oddly, who ordered the calamari?
Oh my god, what? She is incredible with these looks. Like, she painted pink and it was a payoff. I can't. I like this. It is kind of pedestrian. It's a bit more basic than the others. I like the fringe. It's got a concept. I feel like she's going to be safe, but I feel like she needs to step it up on these runways. Okay, it's cute. It's not bad. We've got the same sort of colour palette to what we've been getting with her, and the hair is similar but not the same. But I'm not living. Oh wow, oh my god! She made her way down the runway light as a feather. Wow. That is cute, that is nice, that is kind of like Diana Ross, actually. That is like a different approach to walking the runway. Wow, some good looks here, I'm impressed. Fringe.
It's Britney Bitch Network. You are the winning team.
Best looks from there, Evie Oddly and Nina West. I feel like Evie's won this.
Nina West, congratulations, you are the winner of this week's challenge.
Oh, okay, she was actually better than Evie, but that runway look. Well done, Nina. Evie would have been a close second with that look. Like, that look, just wow.
Team IBBN, you're all safe. You may leave the stage.
You're all in trouble. I don't even know.
As far as the challenge, I wish you guys would have paid a little bit more homage to Mariah Carey. I kept thinking, wait, who are they talking about?
Sort of put the pacing of the whole scene on you because you were the host. You had the role that Nina had in the other group, and she really kind of kept things moving, and it felt to me like the group as a whole felt a little, like, panicked.
In fact, when I visited you all backstage, I got the sense that you guys didn't know a lot about Mariah. I sort of lent you some of my knowledge of Mariah.
Still feel like they should have
used all of it.
That's all the knowledge they had. I feel like they should have just gone with someone different.
You had such a crucial part. You were serving a live conversion, and you were taking some big swings with the
Ariana Grande voice,
but it didn't work.
She kind of looks like Ariana Grande there, though.
A real love for Mariah?
I only found out about pop culture about, like, 3 years ago.
Really?
Wow.
Yeah.
Did they not know Mariah in Vietnam?
No, girl. I came over when I was 11, but I found out about Beyonce legit 4 years ago.
This is where you all could have worked together as a group to educate each other. Mm-hmm. And also, you guys got to choose who you wanted to worship. Was there anybody else that you thought, oh, maybe we should do Madonna, Gaga,
Whitney?
Cher?
Why couldn't they have just done Gaga? Hello?
We all agree that we can get more material from Mariah, but like I said, I'm not really big into the pop culture.
However, that's not really much of an excuse based on the past. Like when Aja didn't know a few things, it is expected to know pop culture, which she does. She says she's known for 4 years. But the blame can't all be put on Plastique.
I don't know if you were like trying to figure out your harmonies or what was going on.
It's either going to be Honey and Raja in the bottom or Sugar and Raja or Sugar and Honey. They're the bomb three.
I don't know why I have been like so in here and not projecting out there.
But honey, and this goes for everyone, look at these divas that we're worshiping. Even they have human moments. But when the light's on, we don't know about it.
Mm-mm. Well, New Year's Eve, Mariah Carey. How dare you bring that up? How dare you bring that up?
Happy New Year, everybody.
It's hard for you not to get watered down.
Like that is like probably the worst look of the runway.
You were a little better.
No, Raja is in the bottom.
The job was to be funny and convert us to the church of Mariah, but the teamwork wasn't there, it wasn't clicking. I was a little bummed out.
It was boring. This is Drag Race, and I was bored.
But I have three words for all of you girls in terms of this challenge. Stink, stank, stunk. I'd like to know from each of you, who's responsible?
I'll take responsibility.
I hope you kick off.
Somebody that I could have really conveyed, we would have done a little better.
So you're blaming yourself?
I'm definitely taking responsibility for my flaws in the challenge, and I know that mine was definitely a big part of it.
I'm gonna say as a whole, we all dropped the ball.
Scarlett, who do you think is responsible for this?
Well, I agree with my sisters. As a team, I don't wanna single anyone out. I mean, I myself flubbed a few puns that I had written down.
What about you, Sugar?
I really do feel the same.
With the same what?
I feel like we all dropped the ball.
What about you, Plastique?
I pretty much agree. We all reached a group consensus of what celebrity that we're gonna do. I came in with the least knowledge, so I was the weak link of the group.
The least knowledge? Well, you know what this competition is. You know what is expected of you. The truth is, if you don't know, you better ask somebody. What about you, Raja?
Doing Mariah, it wasn't something that I just threw out, but I feel like maybe if we would have just took a little bit more time to figure out a diva that we all knew a little bit more about, that we could actually embody the essence.
I feel like they're in trouble. They're getting detention. It's like, you better explain yourself.
I was really let down by Scarlett this week because she did so great last week.
Exactly. But I feel like other team members were worse, so.
As a host, she fell flat for me.
Mm-hmm.
I thought she was actually the best in this group. I mean, that's okay. Not saying much. This group was not great.
Fair enough, maybe I'm just, it's misjudged on my part, but I didn't think she was. She's probably gonna be safe.
Plastique Tierra.
I hope she's
not in the bottom. Out of everybody
excited
me the most. Mm-hmm. I was like, oh, she's gonna nail this. And then it literally went nowhere. Then they started singing and it was literally like, please just stop.
I can understand if people can't sing, but they should just both be in the bottom too. Bye, bitch. Stink, stank, stunk. This was probably worse than the season 7 catastrophe of McBitch.
Y'all need to step your pussy up.
Mm-hmm.
For the
train
first time,
wreck.
Drag Race history. All of you will be lip syncing for your lives.
Oh my God.
What? What? No. Gag. I live. Oh my God. You can't have fucking 6 people lip syncing on the stage. It's hard enough when there's 4 of them. Oh, well, you fucking deserve it, to be fair. All of you sucked. I can't believe this. Wow, oh my God.
The time has come. you lip sync for your life.
There might be a double elimination. Oh my god. There's going to be a double elimination. I can just tell. Send four of them home. Like, I don't even care.
And don't fuck it up.
They already done that, like. It's just, this is a gag. There's six of them, but it is hard to judge who's done good or what, so. I feel like Scarlett's fine, Plastique's fine. Oh my god, whip that ponytail, Ariana Grande, the splits. Akira's not really doing it for, fucking, don't kill yourself, girl. Oh my god, wow. I feel like Sugar's probably gonna be okay. This could be a triple elimination. You're wearing black down there and the floor is black. We can't see you. I don't really want Honey to go, but I feel like Honey and Raja are going. Maybe Akira. These are the two performers. Plastique is seriously giving me life. That was a first, that was something. But I'm curious if it's gonna be a double. Is it gonna be a triple? Like, I'm...
Ladies.
I can't.
I've made my decision. Plastique, Tierra. Shantae, you stay. Raj O'Hare. Shantae, you stay.
What? It's definitely Honey then. Honey's out of here. I'm actually shocked that Raja stayed after that.
Scarlet Envy. Shantae, you stay. Akira C. Davenport.
I think it's gonna be a double.
Shantae, you stay.
Wow. I'm actually happy for Akira. She turns some incredible looks, but no.
Sugarcane. Shantae, you stay.
That was like so harsh. That was the nastiest way. Unless they were gonna do a double.
I'm sorry, my dear, but this is not your time.
That now, sucks.
Sashay away.
I wish I could have shown you more of myself from the moment I walked into the gate, but I thank you for the opportunity to do so. Thank you so much, this is my dream.
I feel bad for her. I know that she has the connection with Manila.
Don't ever let your insecurities come between you and your dreams. Thank you, Ru.
She's a Davenport, she hasn't done the house too proud. She didn't come in strong though, so it sucks, but I like that look.
Can I get an amen up in here?
Amen!
Wow! Okay, so we had six people lip-syncing and one went home. Like, I really did think it was going to be a double elimination though. So this challenge was obviously an acting challenge, like a TV show conversion, and it was an interesting idea. Obviously we had the Britney theme and then the Mariah theme, and it wasn't a really bad challenge. It was okay. I normally like the TV show acting challenges and it was good. Definitely the Britney side, but I feel like the Mariah side just sort of, it made it feel worse and boring. I don't know. What do you guys think? Because the performance was so bad. I do think that it was worse than season 7's McBitch and they all deserve to lip sync. Plus it was a gag. So like it was something different, and we know that it is RuPaul's best gag race right now, so. I mean, Nina definitely deserved to win the challenge. She was great, hilarious in the challenge, and her look was great as well. And They were just such a good team together, seriously. And obviously the Britney theme, I love Britney and all the puns and the references. So cool. And it was definitely the deserving winning team. And that lip sync, girl, like, wow. Like, I don't even know what to say when she said you're all in the box. I was like, wow, this could be a double or a triple elimination. First ever triple elimination. Like, I feel like that could have been something they could have done. But missed opportunities. But I feel like they're like, right, we need this challenge. We got this challenge. It was 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, whatever. So we don't want to do a double elimination. But they still could have done it. Personal thoughts, if it was a double, I feel like it would have been Raja and Honey. Because Raja's look was the bottom out of all 13 looks. And Honey's performance wasn't exactly the best, and neither was Raja. So I thought, obviously, the lip sync, it's based on the lip sync to stay. So Raja obviously did good. But for me, the standouts on the lip sync were Plastique and Scarlett. But with that all being said, we have lost Honey Davenport, which is a shame. And we are now down to 12 queens. But like I said, I'm not doing Tootin' Boots every week, but I just want to quickly talk about some other looks from this episode. At the end, I gave my top two of the week because Evie's look is incredible in the top, seriously. Nina West, I was very impressed, especially after her first 2 weeks of looks. Miss Vanjie's was okay, and Plastic Tiara's was so good. I would say the top three were Evie, Plastic, and Nina. Top two, absolutely Fringe, Pink, Calamari, Umbrella goes to Evie Oddly. I'm so impressed with her. Wow, seriously. I know I was like, oh, she might go home middle of the road when she first came in. First impressions, y'all. But last 2 weeks, her looks have really, really impressed me. And this was just something totally different, extraness. Like, wow. The worst looks for me were definitely Raja and Mercedes and Mon Diamond. Top boot of the week, Raja. So that is pretty much it for this video. Hope you guys all enjoyed it. Give it a thumbs up if you did. And I will be back tomorrow for the live reaction to episode 3's Untucked. So that is everything for this video. Stay opulent. Thank you guys for watching. Bye, guys.
People were talking so much shit about me coming up being weird. And nobody ever had the balls to say it to my face.
Mm-hmm. I think she's triggered from what was said about Silky.
My name sound Muslim. So they put me on the watch list. And I was like, I'm a drag queen. Like, what do you think I'm gonna do?
That's actually ridiculous.
And Troye Sivan.
Troye Sivan! Oh, cool.